As the world prepares for the MCU's Disney Plus shows, it's time to look back on the Marvel TV shows that have already come and gone. There have been many, stretching back to the 1960s, but how do they stack up? These are the best Marvel TV shows according to Rotten Tomatoes. 1992's X-Men, the animated series, distilled everything that made Marvel's mutants so beloved in a truly wild ride that perfectly captures the 90s. The first episode even features Jubilee being pursued by a Sentinel as the X-Men try to save her.
Hey, you! Do you know how much that game costs?
Yeah, a quarter.
Wolverine is at his sneering best alongside Straight Arrow, Cyclops, and Erudite Beast. They're a motley crew, but they have each other, and by hook or by crook, that ends up being enough. It's not all about action, however. The show is just as highly regarded for its romance. There is a familiar love triangle between Cyclops, Wolverine, and Jean Grey, of course, but the tension between the untouchable Rogue and loose cannon Gambit is just as enticing. With that blend of well-crafted character and all-out extreme action, it's no surprise that X-Men stuck around for a full 5 seasons, finally ending in 1997 after 76 stellar episodes. With relatively faithful adaptations of classic X-Men stories like the Dark Phoenix saga, X-Men 92 introduced an entire generation to the greatest superhero soap opera in comics, with all the complexities and weirdness that came with it. As evidenced by its 85% score on Rotten Tomatoes, it's still remembered fondly almost 30 years later. Agent Carter picks up shortly after the apparent death of Steve Rogers in Captain America, the First Avenger, following the post-war adventures of Peggy Carter, played by Hayley Atwell. Stuck as a secretary in the Strategic Scientific Reserve, Peggy gets the chance to do more when Howard Stark recruits her to clear his name after he's accused of treason. Peggy, alongside with Stark's loyal butler Jarvis, embarks upon a double life as a secretary and spy. With a strong lead and fun supporting cast, this show plays both as a stylish period piece and a light-hearted spy romp. Running just 2 seasons from 2015 to 2016, Agent Carter was a critical favorite but ended up cancelled by ABC for low ratings. The fans who did watch it, however, recognized the show as a hidden gem of the MCU, with a genre-breaking attitude and the same quick-witted action that made Peggy a fan favorite on the big screen. As a result, it holds a strong 86% on Rotten Tomatoes. Now that the whole thing is available to stream on Disney+, it's bound to reach an audience that wants to see Peggy as more than just Captain America's long-lost love. The Runaways comic series debuted back in 2003, quickly becoming a hit thanks to a killer premise. Every kid feels like their parents are supervillains sometimes, but what if they actually were? The TV series, which aired on Hulu from 2017 to 2019, takes the idea and expands on it, slowing down the story to give its characters and their villainous parents even more depth than they had on the page. The cast of kids include tech genius Alex Wilder, goth sorceress Nico Minoru, delinquent jock inventor Chase Stein, super strong tween Molly Hernandez, alien celebrity Carolina Dean, and cranky dinosaur whisperer Gertie Yorks. Their interpersonal drama is as important to the show as the actual plot, and fans ate it up. The show deviates from the comics in one major way. In the comics, the kids run away immediately upon discovering that their parents, a group of scientists, criminals, and wizards called the Pride, are engaging in human sacrifice. In the show, the kids hide this fact for the whole first season, only actually running away in the season finale. All in all, it's tense, stylish, and fun, and that's exactly what one wants from a teen super team, earning it an 87% rating from Rotten Tomatoes. Based on the comic created by Bill Mantlo and Ed Hannigan, Cloak & Dagger aired from 2018 to 2019 on the Freeform network. The show makes a few changes from the original comic's premise. Two teens gain powers after being experimented on by drug dealers, recasting Tyrone Johnson and Tandy Bowen with a more modern sensibility. The story of the show is the story of their romance, which shifts and warps while they both gain powers. This leads to something of a mixed tone that attempted to balance superhero action with the feeling of a more traditional teen drama. That didn't stop critics from enjoying it, though. Over the course of its 2 seasons, Cloak & Dagger's adventures earned an 87% rating from Rotten Tomatoes, with plenty of praise for the way the characters evolved from vengeful vigilantes to heroes. Spinning off from Jessica Jones, Luke Cage sees the title hero return to his Harlem roots, battling corruption with the super strength and steel-hard skin he acquired in a prison experiment, and evening the odds against stylish villains like Cottonmouth. The show is slow-paced, but purposefully. Luke Cage is most interesting in the simmering tensions of its world, and its world is a complex one indeed. Even the villains of the show were presented as complex characters who love their home in their own twisted ways, despite their profiting off its woes. The show ran for 2 seasons on Netflix from 2016 to to 2018, racking up an 87% Rotten Tomatoes score with hard-hitting action, a killer soundtrack, and progressive themes that aren't often seen in big-name superhero projects.
I'm tired. But I'm not tired enough to ever let nobody call me that word.
There was particular praise for the incredible cast, including Mike Coulter in the lead role, the great Alfre Woodard as Mariah, and Mahershala Ali, who will soon be returning to Marvel in the all-new Blade. Legion aired for 3 seasons on the FX network from 2017 to 2019, and holds the distinction of being the weirdest and most psychedelic of Marvel's shows, with its fractured narrative being closer to a David Lynch project than a traditional superhero story. Legion doubles down on the weirdness of the original comics, centering much of the first season around a single question: are the things that David Haller experiences a result of mental illness, or the fact that he is the most powerful mutant on Earth? Haller is busted out of his institution by other mutants, notably his future love interest Syd Barrett, all under the supervision of Dr. Melanie Byrd. The breakout character of that sequence is Lenny, Haller's best friend, who gives him increasingly suspicious advice until things take a truly bizarre turn. It's a strange carousel of a story that revels in the weirdest corners of the Marvel Universe's long history, and fans loved every second. More the mainstream MCU movies that the comics are based on are often criticized for following a predictable formula. Legion, on the other hand, was impossible to predict. It's full of unexpected moments, mind-bending dream sequences that might not be dreams, and the occasional dance number thrown in for good measure. It does more with its potential than almost anything else on Marvel's deep bench, which garnered its impressive 91% rating on Rotten Tomatoes. Daredevil ran for 3 seasons from 2015 to 2018 and kicked off the era of Marvel shows on Netflix. It follows blind lawyer Matt Murdock, who decides to become a vigilante when he realizes that his beloved Hell's Kitchen neighborhood is being threatened by Wilson Fisk, the kingpin of crime.
I wanted to make this city something better than it is. Something beautiful!
Alongside his affable law partner Foggy Nelson and secretary Karen Page, Daredevil fights against Fisk and his mobster minions in the courtroom and the streets. In later seasons, Murdock teams up with and clashes against his old girlfriend Elektra, and an intense vigilante nicknamed the Punisher. Not to mention fights against baddies like Bullseye and a whole lot of ninjas. Seriously, just an unbelievable amount of ninjas. Critics were dazzled by the execution of a different kind of show for Marvel Studios, and fans won't forget it anytime soon. As for Rotten Tomatoes, Daredevil clocks in at 92%, proving what we've known all along: people just love hallway fights. Debuting on ABC in 2013 and finishing its 7th and final season in 2020, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. was the first show to bring the Marvel Cinematic Universe to TV. Rather than the superheroes, though, this show focused on the people working at the greatest intelligence organization in comics. The show moves very slowly at first until the events of Captain America: The Winter Soldier, when it's revealed that Hydra has been corrupting S.H.I.E.L.D. for years. After that, the show picks up speed until it's charging forward at a breathless pace, going into some wild directions as a team faces one menace after another. Whether their foe is Hydra, the soul-sizzling mystical power of the hellbound Ghost Rider, the team always finds a way to win.
You're from S.H.I.E.L.D.
Never heard of it.
While it's often ignored by its big-screen cousins, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has earned a dedicated audience from MCU fans and seen plenty of critical praise. So much so, in fact, that Rotten Tomatoes lists it at 94%, the highest rating of any live-action Marvel show. Who knew S.H.I.E.L.D. would wind up being the MCU's best-kept secret? Airing from 2008 to 2009 on Disney XD, The Spectacular Spider-Man makes a number of smart decisions, chief among them hewing closely to the original Stan Lee and Steve Ditko Amazing Spider-Man run while still skipping the origin story everyone already knows. Instead, this cartoon jumps right into his chaotic life, as he tries to balance work, dating, school, his Aunt May, and fighting supervillains. All of the familiar supporting characters are here, including the representatives of Peter Parker's love life, Gwen Stacy, and Mary Jane Watson. Familiar villains like Dr. Octopus and the Green Goblin are key figures, along with lesser-known foes like Tombstone. It's a delightful look back at all the things that make Spider-Man great, and simultaneously, a totally fresh approach to the classic character's canon. Unfortunately, the show was cancelled after 2 seasons in favor of Ultimate Spider-Man. The show received a ton of praise from fans and critics, which might be a little surprising when you consider just how many Spider-Man cartoons are out there for it to compete with. People didn't just think it was good, though. The response was universally positive, granting Spidey the rare 100% rating on Rotten Tomatoes. It turns out that with great power comes great responsibility, and great reviews too. Avengers: Earth's Mightiest Heroes debuted on Disney XD in 2010, 2 years prior to the Avengers making their big screen debut. The show is beloved for its stories that delve deep into comics history, bringing all sorts of classic Avengers storylines to the screen. The siege of Avengers Mansion by the Masters of Evil, the creation of Ultron, the introduction of Thor's alien buddy Beta Ray Bill, all those and many more epics are part of the show's rich superheroic tapestry. It's a triumph of a cartoon, derived from the comics as much as it is from the MCU, capable of entertaining the youngest newbie and the most hardened diehard alike. Unfortunately, the show was cancelled after 2 years in favor of the new Avengers Assemble show. Though leaving behind a legacy of two perfect seasons, it's nothing to be ashamed of. And we do mean perfect. According to Rotten Tomatoes, Earth's Mightiest Heroes stands at a flawless 100%. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.